Hey, fifth graders, I'm Trent. In the fifth grade, you need to learn math concepts for many reasons. Concepts are big ideas. Understanding the big ideas will help you do well on the AIMS test, get better grades in math, and prepare you for math classes in the future.
Plus, it is fun to solve problems and use parts of your brain you have never used before. When I solve a challenging math problem, it makes me feel great. I know the more I learn now, the brighter my future is. My name is Alexis. Let's get on with the show. We hope you enjoy
What's the Big Idea?
The big idea of this video is estimation of whole numbers, fractions, and decimals. There are many advantages to learning to be a good estimator. Good estimators have enough cash when they check out at the grocery store.
At school, good estimators, after solving problems, can determine whether or not their answers are reasonable. To estimate, sometimes you round whole numbers to the nearest 10 or 100. Rounding decimals and fractions to the nearest whole number can help you estimate too.
Before we practice our estimation skills, let's bring in the talented and knowledgeable MVP Jonah, the math vocabulary person.
Thank you, Trent. Today's three vocabulary words are estimation, rounding, and reasonable. Estimation is making an educated guess at an answer. Rounding is taking a whole number, decimal, or fraction, and changing its value to another value that is easier to work with. Reasonable is an adjective that describes an answer that makes sense. If you estimate and round well, you can usually tell if your answers are reasonable. Let's see how these three words relate to each other. Let's say this is your word problem. Jill dances to 9 songs in her dance class. Each song is 3 minutes and 45 seconds in duration. Estimate how long she danced, then figure out exactly how long she danced. There is usually more than one way to solve a problem, but here is one strategy. Round 3 minutes and 45 seconds to 4 minutes. Multiply 4 minutes times 9 dances to get 36 minutes for your estimation. Now do the computation to get an exact answer of 33 minutes and 45 seconds for Jill's dancing. You know that your answer is reasonable because it is a little less than your estimation of 36 minutes.
Thank you, MVP Jonah. The big idea we are talking about here is estimation. Now Alexis will discuss an example of estimation with mixed numbers.
I love family picnics. Aunt Susie brought 3 3/4 pints of whipped cream, and Uncle Rick brought 5 1/8 pints. About how many pints do they have combined? The word about tells us this is an estimation problem. In a quiet voice, tell your neighbor the correct estimation. The best estimation is probably 9 pints, because 4 + 5 = 9. Did you see how rounding and estimating would give us 9? Of course you did.
Here is an estimation problem with money. Money amounts are usually given in decimal form. Bill went to the mall with $20. He bought a t-shirt for $5.75 and a pair of socks for $1.89. About how much money does he have left? Estimate in your head and tell your classmate the correct answer. $20 - $8 = $12. So $12 would be a good estimate.
With practice, estimation is a skill that all fifth graders can master. It will help you develop number sense and solve problems for your entire life.
Thanks for watching. I estimate that our time is up. What's the big idea? Estimation. Learning fifth grade math, big ideas, is awesome. We appreciate your attention and hope you like this video.
Math rocks! For Trent and MVP Jonah, I'm Alexis. See you next time on
What's the big idea?